common terms, meaning utilizing the studying of the evaporative cooling process, we go on to the significance. So evaporative cooling is commonly used in process industries to remove waste heat being generated throughout the process. And two of the preference for employing evaporative cooling equipment is for the maintenance of equipment, and the other one is the environmental considerations. Like what Margaret said a while ago, environmental considerations include those of the conservation of water being used in many industrial processes. So, the significance of studying or evaluating the principles behind evaporative cooling technology is to arrive at the optimum design to which we can increase the efficiencies of the evaporative cooling equipments, like those of the cooling towers. So, cooling tower is one that is most widely used evaporative cooling technology. So, these are the common industrial applications of evaporative cooling technology. The first one is the humidity control of room or plant, where either humidification or the humidification of the inlet air is required. Another one is to use and to recover and cool the water by contacting it with low humidity air. So, as I said a while ago, one of the preference why we install evaporative cooling equipment is to recover the water being used in the process industries. So, for larger cooling duties, the common cooling towers are used. So, in the slide, the common board casings like aluminum, steel, brick, concrete, and asbestos were being used. So, in terms of the scrubbers, evaporative cooling principles is also involved to remove dust from gas steam or for reacting the liquid with a component to the gas stream, as well for the removal of the condensable component of the gas phase. So, next is, largest applications include yung of the recooling of the cooling water used in power plants. So, it is already included in the previously said application. And the humidification is used as a part of a solvent recovery system. So, solvent recovery system is one important application of the evaporative cooling. But, so, let's go on with our, these are some illustrations of the cooling tower. So the first one is to be able to know the significance of cooling towers in the process industries. So that's why we included the major applications of the cooling towers. So the next one is to be able to understand the principle behind evaporative cooling process using cooling towers. And the third one is to be able to know the difference between mechanical draft cooling towers and natural draft cooling towers. This another objective is to be able to know the application of cooling towers in process industries, and last is to determine that and evaluate the cooling tower characteristics. So after that, Christy will discuss the parts of the equipment being used.